First of all, we will discuss about ordered pairs. You must be aware that two numbers A and B listed in a specific order and enclosed form an ordered pair A and B. We call A as first member or first component and B as second member or second component. By interchanging the position of the components, the ordered pairs are changed. If we have two non-empty sets A and B, then a relation R from A to B is a subset of A cross B, that is Cartesian product of A and B. If ordered pair AB belong to R, then we say A is related to B. We can draw arrow diagram representing relations. For this, we draw two bounded figures to denote the two sets A and B. We put dots to represent the elements of set A and set B. Then, for each ordered pair A and B, we draw an arrow from A to B. Now, types of relations. There are basically three types of relations: reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. If a particular relation satisfies certain conditions of reflexivity or symmetry or transitivity, then it is categorized as being reflexive or symmetric or transitive. If a relation satisfies all three conditions, then it is called an equivalence relation. In mathematics, typically, you come across relations such that line L is perpendicular to line M, 42 is divisible by 7, or set A is a subset of set B. In set theory, a relation describes a possible connection between the elements of a set. Consider set A of regular polygons consisting of a square, a pentagon, and a hexagon. Let R1 be the relation that stands for sum of any two angles of any two polygons is less than 180 degrees. Since sum of no two angles of any two polygons is less than 180 degrees, therefore, no element of this set is related to any other element of it. Thus, R1 is an empty relation in set A. Hence, R is equal to empty set phi, which is the subset of A cross A. Consider the same set A of regular polygons. Let R2 be the relation that stands for sum of any two angles of any two polygons is greater than or equal to 180 degrees. Since any two angles of any two polygons in the given set have the sum of their angles more than or equal to 180 degrees, therefore, each element of the set is related to every other element of the set. Hence, the relation R2 is a universal relation in set A. A relation R in set A is said to be reflexive if every element of set A is related to itself. Let us assume that T is the set of all triangles in a plane and that triangle ABC belongs to this set. Further, let us assume that the relation R stands for is congruent to. As every triangle is congruent to itself implies that the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABC. In other words, the relation R is reflexive in set T. The relation R in set A is said to be symmetric if A is related to B implies that B is related to A for all A and B belonging to set A. Let us consider the same set T, which is a set of all triangles in a plane, and that the triangles ABC and DEF are two elements of the set T. In addition, if the relation R stands for is congruent to and triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF, then we can say that triangle DEF is also congruent to triangle ABC. Conclusively, the relation R is symmetric in set T. In set T, if triangle ABC, triangle DEF and triangle PQR are three elements of set T and triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF and triangle DEF is congruent to triangle PQR, then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. In other words, the relation R is transitive in set T. Thus, a relation R in a set A is said to be transitive if A is related to B and B is related to C implies that A is related to C for all A, B and C belonging to the set A. A relation R in a set A is an equivalence relation if the relation R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. For the same set T of triangles, since the relation is congruent to, is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, therefore R is an equivalence relation. Hun tak tusi types of relations bare janya hai, aao hun is te adharit kuch udaharan nu hal kariye. Now let's see an example. Let A is the set containing elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and B is the set containing elements 1, 4 and 5. Let R be a relation is less than from set A to set B. Then list the elements of R and depict the relation by arrow diagram. Pav, maan lo set A jiste elements han 1, 2, 3, 4 ate 5 ate set B jiste elements han 1, 4, 5. Maan lo R set A to set B tak is less than ek relation hai. Ta R de elements likho ate relation nu arrow diagram nal darshao. Now its solution, given set A whose elements are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and set B whose elements are 1, 4 and 5. Given that relation R, which is relation is less than from set A to set B. So, ordered pairs of R can be written as R equal to the set of ordered pairs 1, 4, 1, 5, 2, 4, 2, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5 and 4, 5 because as per relation which is less than. So in every element or in every ordered pair, element A is less than element B. For example, in ordered pair 1, 4, 1 is less than 4. In ordered pair 1, 5, 1 is less than 5. In ordered pair 2, 4, 2 is less than 4. In ordered pair 2, 5, 2 is less than 5. In ordered pair 3, 4, 3 is less than 4. And in ordered pair 3, 5, 3 is less than 5. In ordered pair 4, 5, 4 is less than 5. So, these are the elements. Of R. Now we will represent the elements of R with the help of arrow diagram. As a given sets R, set A and set B. Elements of set A are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Elements of set B are 1, 4, 5. And the given relation R, which is less than. Here, element 1 of set A is less than element 4 of set B. Therefore, we can say that element 1 relates to element 4 of set B with the given relation R. In the same way, element 1 of set A is less than element 5 of set B. Therefore, we can say that element 1 relates to element 5 of set B with the same relation R. Similarly, 2 relates with element 4 with the given relation R. 2 relates with element 5 with the given relation R. Also, 3 relates with element 4 with the given relation R. 3 also relates to element 5 of the set B with the same relation R. And last, element 4 relates to element 5 of set B with the same relation R. Therefore, all the ordered pairs 1, 4, 1, 5, 2, 4, 2, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5 and 4, 5 are represented by arrow diagram. Jo ki assi darshauna si. Now let's see another example. Determine whether greater than or equal to is a reflexive relation for natural numbers. Pav, ए पता करो कि greater than or equal to एक reflexive relation है natural numbers वास्ते. Now its solution, relation R is defined as relation on natural numbers say n as ordered pair xy belongs to R
implies that x is greater than equal to y for all x, y belonging to the set of natural numbers. Now, constructing some data we take first three natural numbers 1, 2, 3. Now, for y equal to 1, x will be equal to 1, 2, 3, because as per given relation, if ordered pair xy belongs to R, then x is greater than equal to y. Now, for y equal to 2, x is equal to 2, 3. Now, for y equal to 3, x will be equal to 3. Thus, the relation set is R equal to the set of ordered pairs as 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, two, two, three, two, and three, three. Now, this set consists of relation of all the elements of the set which are related to itself that is ordered pair 1, 1, ordered pair 2, 2 and ordered pair 3, 3 belongs to the relation set R where 1, 2, 3 are natural numbers . So if we generalize we conclude that this relation R is a reflexive relation on natural numbers सो इस तरह से कह सकते हैं द्वितीय रिलेशन इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू नेचुरल नंबर्स होते एक रिफ्लेक्सिव रिलेशन है जो कि ऐसी पता करना से।
हुण तक तुसी टाइप्स ऑफ रिलेशंस ते आधारित कुछ उदाहरणों नु हल कीता है, आओ हुण इस ते आधारित कुछ होर उदाहरणों नु हल करिए।
Now let's see an example. Let R be a relation on Q defined by R is equal to set of all ordered pairs AB such that AB belongs to the set of rational numbers Q and A minus B belongs to the set of integers. Then show that R is a symmetric relation. Pub मान लो R सेट के ऊपर डिफाइन एक रिलेशन है जो कि इस तरह डिफाइन है R बराबर उना सारे ऑर्डर्ड पेयर ए बी का सेट जदों कि ए अते बी रैशनल नंबर्स होन अते ए माइनस बी इंटीजर होवे ता दर्शाओ कि R एक सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन है। नाउ इट्स सॉल्यूशन वी नो दैट इन अ सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन R on a set A if ordered pair AB belongs to R, this implies that ordered pair BA will also belongs to R for all AB belonging to the given set A. Also we can say that A relates to B implies that B relates to A for all AB belonging to set A. Here given relation R is defined on set of rationals as R is equal to set of all ordered pairs such that AB belongs to set of rational numbers Q and A minus B belongs to set of integers Z. Let ordered pair AB belongs to the given relation R implies that A minus B belongs to the set of integers, that is A minus B is an integer. Further implies that minus of A minus B will also be an integer. Because we know that additive inverse of an integer is also an integer, this further implies B minus A is an integer. So this implies that ordered pair BA belongs to the given relation R. Thus we can say that if ordered pair AB belongs to the given relation R implies that ordered pair BA will also belong to the given relation R. Hence, we can say that the given relation R is symmetric. उत्पाद इस तरह से कह सकते हैं जेकर ऑर्डर पेयर ए बी दूसरी रिलेशन आर नू बिलोंग करता होवे ता ऑर्डर पेयर बी ए भी रिलेशन आर नू बिलोंग करेगा जदों की ए अते बी रैशनल नंबर्स होन। इस तरह से कह सकते हैं दूसरी रिलेशन आर सिमेट्रिक है जो कि असी दर्शाना सी। Now let's see another example. Let R is the set of all ordered pairs AB such that AB are integers and A minus B is even. Then show that the given relation R is an equivalence relation on the set of integers Z. Pav, मान लो R उना सारे ordered pairs AB दा set है जदों की A अते B integer होन अते a माइनस b इवन होवे ता दर्शाओ कि रिलेशन r सेट z उते एक इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन है। नाउ इट्स सॉल्यूशन वी नो दैट अ रिलेशन व्हिच सेटिस्फाई द फॉलोइंग कंडीशंस ऑफ रिफ्लेक्सिव सिमेट्रिक एंड ट्रांजिटिव रिलेशंस इज एन इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन। हियर the given relation R is defined as R is the set of all ordered pairs such that A, B are integers and A minus B is even. So now, to check the given relation R is an equivalence relation or not, we will check out whether it satisfies the conditions of reflexive, symmetric, and transitive relations or not. So first of all we will check the given relation R is reflexive or not. We know that the given relation is reflexive if ordered pair AA belongs to R for all A belonging to the given set A, that is A relates to itself for all A belonging to set A. For the relation being reflexive on set A, here A is an integer, then A minus A is equal to 0, which is even number. Therefore, we can say that ordered pair AA belongs to R for all A being integer. So, R is a reflexive relation. Now we will check whether relation R is symmetric or not. We know that if a relation R is symmetric, then if ordered pair AB belongs to R implies that ordered pair BA will also belongs to R for all AB belonging to the given set A, that is, for a symmetric relation, if A relates to B, implies that B will also relate to A with the similar symmetric relation for all AB belonging to the given set A. Here, ordered pair AB belongs to the set R for all AB belonging to the set of integers, then it implies that A minus B is even further implies minus of A minus B is also even because we know that for an even number its additive inverse is also even further implies B minus A is also even implies that ordered pair BA also belongs to R. Thus, if ordered pair AB belongs to R implies that ordered pair BA also belongs to R for all AB which are integers. So, we can say that relation R is a symmetric relation . Now we will check whether given relation R is transitive or not. We know that in a transitive relation, R defined on a set A if ordered pair AB belongs to R and ordered pair BC also belongs to R implies that ordered pair AC belongs to R for all ABC belonging to the given set A, that is, if A relates to B and B relates to C with the given transitive relation R, implies that A relates to C for all ABC belonging to the given set A. Here, A, B, C are integers. Let ordered pair AB belongs to R and ordered pair BC also belongs to R implies that A minus B is even and B minus C is also even as per the given relation R is defined. So this further implies A minus B plus B minus C is also even, because we know that sum of two even numbers is also even. So this implies that A minus C is even, implies that ordered pair AC belongs to R. Therefore, ordered pair AB belongs to R and ordered pair BC belongs to R implies that ordered pair AC also belongs to R for all A, B, C belonging to the set of integers. So, relation R is transitive. Since the given relation R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, hence we can say that relation R is an equivalence relation. ਪਾਵ ਹੁਣ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਰ ਰਿਫਲੈਕਸਿਵ ਸਿਮੈਟ੍ਰਿਕ ਅਤੇ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਜ਼ਿਟਿਵ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਲਈ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਹਿ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਰ ਇੱਕ ਇਕਵੀਵੈਲੈਂਸ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਦਰਸਾਉਣਾ ਸੀ
ਆਓ ਹੁਣ ਦੁਹਰਾਈਏ ਇਸ ਐਪੀਸੋਡ ਵਿੱਚ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕੀ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਹੈ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਰ ਇਨ ਸੈਟ ਏ ਇਜ਼ ਸੈਡ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਐਮਪਟੀ if no element of set A is related to any element of it. A relation R in set A is said to be universal if each element of set A is related to every element of set A. A relation R in set A is reflexive if every element of set A is related to itself. A relation R in set A is symmetric if A is related to B implies that B is related to A for all A and B belonging to set A. A relation R in set A is transitive if A is related to B and B is related to C implies that A is related to C for all A, B and C belonging to set A. If a relation R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, then the relation R is called an equivalence relation. Is episode which to see types of relation bare sikhya hai. Umeed karda haan, tuhanu episode puri tarah samajh aa gaya hovega. Dhanwad.